Hello and welcome to part 10 of the first of the three weekly lessons about Oracle Jet. Oracle Jet includes a collection of components, patterns, and enhanced HTML tags that you can use to control the visual layout of your Jet applications. In this part, you will be introduced to the Oracle Alta UI design system and to the support for Flex layout, which is part of CSS3. In the second of the weekly lessons about Jet, we will spend more time on this topic, and you will learn how to use each of the related parts in more detail. The Oracle Alta UI design system is a set of CSS classes that are used to develop the most recent Oracle Cloud products, including a number of innovative mobile applications, with many more to come. In particular, Oracle Alta UI focuses on helping you to create user interfaces that are conducive to responsive design techniques. Oracle Alta UI is the default theme of Oracle Jet. For example, the Oracle Jet templates are laid out using Oracle Alta UI. Also, as you saw in the previous parts of this course, the Oracle Alta UI CSS style sheets are included to let you style your applications quickly and easily. The Flexbox layout is a standard part of CSS3. It aims to provide an efficient way to lay out, align, and distribute space among items in a container, even when their size is unknown and or dynamic. The main idea behind the Flex layout is to give the container the ability to alter the width, height, and order of its items to best fill the available space. In turn, this helps to accommodate your application to all kinds of display devices and screen sizes. A Flex container expands items to fill available free space or shrinks them to prevent overflow. Via Oracle Jet CSS classes, the Flexbox layout has been integrated into Oracle Jet and can easily be used as you work on your Jet applications. Having discussed Flexbox, let's now see how easy it is to use in our Oracle Jet applications. Here we are back in our application. As before, we have items in the navigation list for loading each of our modules. In this case, we're going to look at our Customers module and play a bit with OJ Flex and OJ Flex item here. Back in our development environment, we're in our customer's HTML file, and we have a div, and we use the CSS class here, OJFlex. This is a Flex container. Within the div with the class set to OJFlex, we create another div where we use OJFlexItem. And we add a few more. Now we have a Flex container containing three Flex items. Back in the browser, we see nothing. Let's go back and we will add here a panel, OJ panel. And we will do the same for the other ones. And go back into the browser. Now we see three panels horizontally next to each other, but they're very close, probably not what we want. And there is another class to help us here called OJ Margin. And let's use OJ Margin here and also here. Now, back in the browser, we see there's a small space between each of them. What you can also do to distinguish between them is to use OJ panel and then L1, L2, L3, L4, L5, each of which defines a different background color. For example, we put L1 here and let's put L2 there and OJ panel L2. 5 there, for example, and look again in the browser. Now we see three different background colors. Something else that we can do here is organize Flex items within other Flex items. This is possible if a Flex item, in addition to being a Flex item, is also a Flex container. Here we have our Flex item, our first Flex item, and in here what we're going to do is we're going to set this Flex item to be a Flex 2. And then within that Flex container, we're going to add a few other flex items. And to distinguish between them, we're going to use different alt backgrounds here. We save this, we look in the browser, and now we see that we have two flex items within our first flex item, which is also now a flex container. The point of the exercise is that we want to have a layout that looks equally good when the resolution changes. So we'll make the resolution of the browser smaller, and we see that the content still looks good. Everything is evenly spaced out. When we make it larger again, everything refits itself automatically. This is called responsive design. Now imagine that we would like to have these two items not next to each other, but vertically organized, the one above the other. For that, Jet provides a class called OJSM Flex Direction Column. We save this, go back into the browser, and we notice that now the two are organized in a column. When we change resolution again, notice everything again fits perfectly. What is this SM about? SM stands for small, and what we are saying here is that from the small resolution onwards, the direction of the two items within this flex container will be in a column. We can also say here SM only. And so here we are saying that the items within the container will be in a column only if the resolution is small. Back in the browser, we see the two next to each other, and now we change the resolution to small, and under these circumstances, we see that the two items are organized in this way. In this part, you have been introduced to two of the most important JET features that help you control the visual layout of your JET applications. For your homework exercise, play around with different layout options. Try nesting OJFlex and OJFlex item classes to see how different combinations behave. Finally, with the knowledge you have now gained through the first week, you should have enough information to create JET applications yourself. Starting from next week, we will examine the full range of JET components, and you will learn how to get the most out of them when putting your own JET applications together.